Rooted in teaching tradition, the desire to impact lives through education formed our leatherneck way of life.
Here, a leatherneck doesn't salute to how things have always been, but instead envisions a world that is full of possibility. At Western, a leatherneck is courageous. A leatherneck is a creative, outside-the-box thinker, bold and big-hearted. A leatherneck is someone who trailblazes ahead into the unknown.
From around the world to right here in Illinois, in every sex, shape, color, or creed, we stand together as leathernecks, fearless and loyal.
At Western, we believe every student with the hope to succeed deserves to thrive at our institution. We're invested in honing each student's individual strengths to turn that hope into promise. Our commitment shows in everything that we do.
In Macomb and the Quad Cities, all walks of life meet to share cultures, ideas, and aspirations. Our students bring a new perspective and a forward-thinking mindset that will help them wherever they go next.
Whatever the next challenge we face, we strengthen and evolve. With fortitude, we remain devoted to our leatherneck fighting spirit.
When we stand together, we stand up for what matters, going forth as one. And that unity takes us far beyond what we ever imagined.
The world needs leathernecks like you.
Thank you to everyone who's here today, and thank you to the many people who are watching on the live stream. I know it's a holiday weekend and traveling is common. So I just want to say a few words about the repertoire I selected today. The Beethoven Horn Sonata is one of my favorite pieces. I first heard it when I listened to a recording called Deep Remembering, and it was recorded by Gail Williams, and then she became my teacher. So it lives in my heart, and it's just, I play it every time I can, anytime I have a wonderful collaborative pianist to work with, like Yeon-Kyung here. So, and thank you to Yeon-Kyung. Let's give her another round of applause for the Beethoven. This next piece actually wasn't supposed to be this way, but I was taking a deep dive in graduate school, just trying to find every recording that my now former teacher, Gail Williams, had made. And I came across a CD with her and her husband, Larry Combs. Those of you who know or don't know Larry, he was the principal clarinetist of the Chicago Symphony for many decades, and they recorded a significant amount of chamber music repertoire for horn and clarinet. This piece by George Rochberg is quite different. It's nothing like the Beethoven you just heard. It's full of really exciting harmonies and melodies and drama, and a lot of opportunities for us as performers to take liberties and do something soloistic and then also work together. So I hope that you will enjoy listening to this piece as much as the three of us have enjoyed collaborating on it. Thank you so much. So to end the program, I thought we'd have a little, clear the air after that rock burg that's so heavy and full of interesting harmonies, and end with a duet, a jazz duet, originally written for bass trombone and trombone, but I think it sounds pretty cool on tuba and horn, and I'm joined by my colleague, Dr. Land, here. So thank you very much for coming today, everyone who's here. This will be short and sweet. I appreciate your being here and hearing some great chamber music for horn.
Thank you.